Hysterectomy, or removal of the uterus, is one of the most common surgeries in the United States. About 600,000 are done each year. It can be life-changing, even life-saving, for people who need it. If you have questions about hysterectomy or whether it can be an option for you, here are some things to know. A hysterectomy may be recommended as part of a treatment plan for some health conditions, such as abnormal uterine bleeding, uterine fibroids, pelvic support problems, uterine prolapse, endometriosis, and gynecologic cancer. There are three types of hysterectomy. A supracervical hysterectomy removes the upper part of the uterus, but the cervix remains. This is often used when treating conditions such as fibroids or prolapse. A simple or total hysterectomy removes the uterus and cervix. This is the most common type of hysterectomy done. A radical hysterectomy removes the uterus and cervix along with the surrounding tissue. This includes removing the upper portion of the vagina and the tissue around the cervix. A radical hysterectomy may be recommended if cancer is diagnosed or suspected. In some cases, a salpingectomy may be done. This is when the fallopian tubes are removed, often in an effort to reduce the risk of ovarian cancer. Your surgeon may also recommend an oophorectomy. This is when the ovaries are removed. Your surgeon may not know whether the ovaries, fallopian tubes, or both will need to be removed until the time of surgery. Talk with your OBGYN about your surgical plan. The plan will depend on why you are having the hysterectomy and other factors, like your future risk of cancer. Most hysterectomies can be done through the vagina with no incisions on your abdomen, or through the abdomen with small incisions and a laparoscope. Sometimes, the way a hysterectomy is done may be changed after surgery has started and the surgeon is able to see whether there are other problems. In some cases, the uterus may need to be removed through a larger incision on the abdomen. After a hysterectomy, you may need to stay in the hospital for up to a few days, or you may be able to go home the same day. In either case, it can take up to 4 weeks to fully recover. After surgery, be sure to follow your surgeon's instructions, get plenty of rest, move around as often as you can, avoid tampons, douching, and vaginal sex while you're healing from the hysterectomy. Watch for fever, signs of an infection, heavy bleeding, blood clots, or problems passing stool. Each day, you should feel a little better than the day before. If you ever feel like you're feeling worse than the day before, call your surgeon. There are several common side effects you can expect during the recovery period. You may have bleeding and discharge from your vagina for several weeks. You can use sanitary pads, but don't use tampons. You can expect to have some pain for the first few days after surgery. Before your hysterectomy, talk with your surgeon about what pain medications you can use at home. You may take prescription pain medication or an over-the-counter medication. Constipation is also common after most hysterectomies. Some women may have temporary problems with emptying the bladder. There may also be longer-term side effects. If your ovaries are removed, you can expect hot flashes and other symptoms of menopause. Removal of the ovaries can also increase your risk of bone loss and osteoporosis. Talk with your OBGYN about medications that may help with both menopausal symptoms and bone loss. Keep in mind that a hysterectomy is still major surgery, even if done with small incisions. You need to give yourself time to heal. Your OBGYN, family, and friends can help support you through your recovery. Remember, in addition to physical healing, it's also common to have emotional reactions to having a hysterectomy. After you recover, you should continue to see your OBGYN for routine gynecologic exams and general health care. Hysterectomy has come a long way in the 21st century and can be life-changing, even life-saving, for people who need one. In time, you should be able to get back to the things you like to do.